This is question number 9, and again, since we have graphs and just numbers to put in, we're going to do it right on here. So for the A question, the graphs of the function g and h are shown. For each graph, find the absolute maximum. That means the highest of the high. Absolute minimum, the lowest of the low. Okay, if no such values exist, click on none. So this first graph, we're looking for the highest, the maximum, so absolute maximum of g. And when they didn't say absolute maximum value, but that's really what they're talking about. They're not looking for the x value. The x value is a location. So they would ask, where is the maximum? That's where we would do the x value. They want the absolute maximum of g, the value of g. So they're looking for the y value. And we can see right here, y equal 2 is the highest value. So I always think like birds, you know, they always want to go up to the highest part. So where would the bird go? It would go up here to the highest part where it can see everything. And there's nothing higher than 2. Absolute minimum, now we can see the lowest point here is at negative 4. But what's happening here is we got this arrow which says it's going to keep going down. Even if the arrow was like up here, it doesn't matter. This arrow says it's going to keep going forever. And this is a vertical asymptote. We remember what happens there, that the graph next to an asymptote will keep going to negative infinity. So in that case, there is no minimum. We keep going forever. Okay. Graph of h, absolute maximum. So again, we're looking for the highest of the high, and we can see it up here. If I was a bird, I would want to fly to this top level, and so I can see everything. And that's a y equals 4. Okay, so these are maximum values, those are y values. The absolute minimum value would be the lowest, and we can see that's happening here down at negative 5, y equals negative 5. And that's a solid point. Now, they've got an open point here, and this, let me talk about that. That's not really a minimum, because as you come down, you get closer and closer to it, but there's no exact, you can keep getting closer. You can keep actually getting a lower and lower y value. There is no way to stop. Again, we've got a limit. We don't get any lower than negative 4, but we keep getting closer and closer to negative 4. This one's not in the running anyway, because there's one clearly lower than it. But just in case, you know, had this been down lower than it, we would have had to go with a none if it was an open. Or let's say this was an open circle, then we would say none. But since it's a closed circle, we actually do arrive at negative 5 as a y value, and these are the answers that we get to.